Hey guys, in this video, I'm gonna show you how I extracted this upper left first molar through sectioning and elevating. Like, I'm hugely biased towards sectioning. I think it's a great skill to have as a dentist. It makes my extractions more predictable. I could have potentially removed it without sectioning, but I just think it'd be too much work. To try and get some forceps on this tooth or just purely luxation, it's not so easy in my hands. I find sectioning much easier. Now, two big issues here that we take care of on this 71-year-old patient who's otherwise medically fit and healthy. Have a look at the mess there of this upper left second premolar, this caries mess here. So I tell the patient, look, you could sneeze and this tooth can break away. We need to deal with this tooth. We need to extract it. But she wasn't ready yet to have this one out. So we're gonna come back and do some treatment plan discussions. So that's why that's still in there. But I warned her that as I'm removing the first molar, the forces may dislodge that tooth. So always be very, very careful to warn your patients of teeth like these. It'll also give me an opportunity to see if that's caries once the tooth is removed. And yes, it's a little bit close to the sinus over here. That doesn't worry me so much. I just warned the patient, it's very close to the sinus, as you can see on the x-ray. If there's a communication, I will deal with it, okay? So that's my level of consent. Some of the challenging things here is that this is all mushy caries, and we see this nice, thick, bulbous root of the mesial. So for me, I'm definitely gonna be sectioning. Okay guys, so here's the clinical video of the extraction. Upper left first molar, very carious. I'm just topping up some anesthetic because there was an infected area there. I'm now gonna be very carefully using a luxator. I don't wanna put too much pressure on that very dodgy second premolar. I'm reflecting away some of the tissues palatally. It's a good thing to do if you ever suspect that you could have a tuberosity fracture. I didn't worry about that here, but it's just a habit I got into. I'm using my electric handpiece here with a diamond burr to section the mesial buccal and distal buccal, and then continue to make the Mercedes sign or the T sign to also section the palatal root. So we split into three roots, mesial buccal, distal buccal, and palatal. So I do that with electric handpiece without a flap. So electric, not air driven, and no flap. There's no risk of surgical emphysema. I'm getting right to the bone. I want to see some bleeding, okay? So bleeding is a good thing to see when you are sectioning. I'm now using some luxators, again, very carefully. And which root do you remove first? I know some people have a preference, you know, Chris Waith likes to go for the disto buccal root first always. I just like to see whichever root wants to come out first, okay? And in this case, it actually was the distal buccal root. It wanted to come out first. It was showing me the most potential, the most mobility. So once I get some movement, there we are, lovely movement there. I'm ready to get some sort of root forceps on, give it a gentle, good grip, but a gentle twist. You don't wanna overdo it too quick, because then that's when things fracture. So I wanna get a nice movement, and there we are. We lifted up that distal buccal root. I'm then gonna go again, luxate, luxate, luxate. The palatal root here is looking like it wants to come out next. So what I will do here, once I've got it pretty loose, I've done most of my work with my luxators, elevators. I'm gonna use some criers. There we are, just to lift it up. It's a way to deliver the root. I'm gonna try criers here on the mesial buccal root, and it's not budging. Now, how long do I spend before I decide that, okay, I need to move to something else because this is not working? 6 seconds. It's a tip I picked up from an oral surgeon once. So 6 seconds with the criers, it's not working. I'm now gonna move to my luxators. 6 seconds, I'm getting some mobility. I'm happy. I'm now gonna go to my root forceps. It's working straight away, and that's good. We have done our extraction. We now check, is there any debris? We see some debris there. We see some calculus. I see some infection there, so I'm gonna scrape away that infection. I'm gonna get the socket nice and clean. I'm gonna make sure there's no bony fragments, toothy fragments in there. I'm checking for an oral antral communication, and there wasn't one, so happy days. And to grab onto that infection that I see right at the base of the socket, I use some needle holders here just to get right to the base, grab hold of the infection, and take it out. So you'll see that in just a second. We want a nice, clean socket. We don't want any infection if it can be helped. You need good magnification. You need good lighting to do this kind of work. And I think, I think over the years, as I've been more meticulous about cleaning the socket, I've had less and less dry sockets. So there we are. I didn't actually suture this one because look at it. It looks like a normal socket to me. I haven't caused too much damage. Hope you enjoy that. If you want more of these kind of videos, do join my newsletter as well. So you get an email when some of these videos come out with all my other sort of podcast content. You can visit protrusive.co.uk/emails to get that. Thanks so much for watching all the way to the end, and do share it with a colleague who may be struggling with sectioning and elevating. Thank you.